Hello once again, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 35th Scale Figures in Review. First of all, I'd like to thank all my subscribers that I've picked up so far, and we're coming up on about 700 views of the various videos I've made, and I've made six of them. This is number seven on its way. Tonight, we're going to review the great Stalingrad figures out of Russia. This particular figure is the Russian infantryman, Berlin 1945. These resin figures are very highly detailed. They have a wide variety of World War I figures, Russian infantry, civilians at different times of the war. Plus, like I said, they've kind of branched out into their World War I figures, as well as I believe they have a Tiger tank crew set up to go on the interiors of some of these new great kits we have. I'd like to thank Chris Marcel of CRM Hobbies for letting me get this purchase of his various Stalingrad figures. I've been purchasing figures from Chris for many years, and this is one of the better ones that I've been able to pick up. So, sit back, take a peek, and enjoy as we get that ball rolling for this review. Okay, I'm gonna do a little something different today on our review of our Stalingrad figure. I'm just gonna show you a few that I have collected over the years. And once again, these purchases are all from CRN Hobbies. Okay. Our first guy is going to be a grenadier from the Grossdeutschland division of the German army in 43 at Kharkov. Okay, this next one I have is a infantryman from the Cherkassy pocket in 1944, the winter of. These, I believe, were soldiers that were headed to relieve the pocket when that occurred in that winter battle. Here's another one, MG42. Soldier that was another German soldier going to relieve the pocket in the winter of 44. And then now we go to our Berlin guys. Okay, these are beautiful renditions of Soviet soldiers in the street fighting in Berlin. This one is carrying the famous Panzerfaust. And then we're going to go ahead and take a look at our guy right here. This is a machine gunner of the Soviets as they went into Berlin for the street fighting. And we'll go ahead and get him opened up right away. Okay, the Stalingrad boxes are outstanding as far as the color that they have. They're smaller boxes. They have a good looking picture of the model that's inside right away, as you see here. You have the Russian terminologies on this side of the package. Okay. You have on the back side, you have a good picture of some tank riders going into Berlin. Okay, and then on this side, you have the English explanations of things. Okay, so once again, very, very nice packaging. We'll go ahead and now begin opening this guy up as we do with all of our kits. Now, the Stalingrad figures come with only one head, and it is unattached. So it might make painting just a little bit easier. He has one interior plastic packet and one full-length body right here. Okay, in this first packet right here, or the only other packet, you're going to find his head, his arms, and the machine gun, the PPSH submachine gun that the Germans liked so well and the Russians used all the time. Okay, we'll go ahead and take a good look at this right here. This is the machine gun that he has. And with the machine gun, the nice thing about this one is, or uniqueness is, that he has the hands already attached to the machine gun. As I kind of do a little bit of a turn right here, you see that you have the hand right there on the drum of the weapon. The hand is also attached right here by the trigger and by the handle. You see the resin carrier right here, and very nicely, there's not very thick attachment points, which is always a gigantically huge plus when dealing with our resin guys. Okay, this next carrier that we have right here is the arms of our machine gunner. You'll see that the pockets are slightly hollowed out, okay, that you can put the hands right into. The carrier right here, and it's a very slim, very thin attachment piece of resin right there on the arms. Okay, it won't take very much at all for a little razor saw action, some trimming, and some fine sanding, and then you're going to be ready to go. And then here is the head. Our gentleman, once again, not too bad. Okay, he has his cap on just like the Russians would. Sometimes they wore their steel helmets. A lot of times you saw them with their with a simple cloth cap on. Great facial expression on this guy. Once again, the resin block carrier isn't very thick. You can see the attachment point that's right here. Should be very easy to clean up. And the last, but by far not least, is the full-length body that we have of this gentleman. Okay, and he is done very, very well. He's wearing his jacket over the top. This is the winter coat that they have that is quilted. Okay, here's his ammo pouches right there for the submachine gun. He has a hand grenade that's located right here along his belt. Okay, here's the pants that he has and his high boots. You see the nice fold of the clothing. The clothes just drape very nicely over the top of the body. You see the good wrinkles that you have right there, the leather boots. Over here on the slow turn that we have to the back side of this guy. Now, a lot of times the Russians did not have backpacks. They would often carry all of their goods in a Russics bag that they would just sling over their shoulders and carry on their backs like this. You see he has his field blouse underneath right here, and then here's a jacket with the fine quilted pattern of it that's typical of a Russian winter coat at this time. You see, once again, the folds come down very nicely right here. Okay, open collar, this placement of the head will go right here. Nice smooth areas for the arms. And so once again, great looking figure here from Stalingrad. All right, and in just a little bit, I'll be right back with a completed figure put together. And as always, okay, following the video portion, I will have a series of stills of the completed figure itself, and then also some period pictures of what some of the Russians looked like when they got into the street fighting in Berlin and what their outfits looked like in color. So stay tuned and we'll be right back for that. Okay, here's our put together Russian machine gunner in Berlin, 1945. And I will say this is an excellent figure put together for the Stalingrad company. Now I did something a little bit different again. I pinned the hands because I knew it was going to be a little bit harder trying to get the rifle machine gun put together. Since the hands and arms were separate, I put little pins in it and it went together a lot better than I thought. As a matter of fact, his left arm fits so well that it's not even glued on there. As you go around, you see how well his head sits looking down the gun sight. As we continue our turn coming around here, the details, once again, of him put together are excellent. You see the folds of his clothing as I can come over here, okay, and his jacket. You see the backpack, the Russic sack all attached here. You see, once again, his boots are sitting where they are, okay. He has underneath his jacket, he's got his field blouse sitting there. And we continue coming around, and he looks excellent. Okay, this is, I'm very, very impressed. This is one of my first Stalingrad figures I've ever dealt with and put together, even though I have a few in my collection. And they are going to be well worth it. There was minimal cleanup for him. It is a little bit of a challenge with any figure that has separate hands and separate arms molded on the weapon to try to put them together. But he went together very, very well, and I'm surprised with that much ease. As you come around here, you can see his ammunition pouch is sitting right here. The head that's separate has a great lean to coming into the gun sight. You see the hands sit naturally right on the machine gun themselves. And I'll continue to turn and we'll get a bird's eye view of him coming right down the barrel at you. Okay, so once again, like I said before, all in all, this figure is excellent. And there he is looking right down the barrel at you. Okay, so that is a great figure from Stalingrad, and I highly recommend these figures. Once again, the head is in attached, and we come around, and there he's looking down his machine gun. So, following this, I'll have a few stills. I'll get some painting ideas from some pictures I've taken, and also one slide from the Berlin conflict, and you should have a good picture. So, once again, thanks everybody for turning in to 35th Scale Figures in Review. I'd like once again to thank Chris Mercel from CRN Hobbies, and make sure you stop in at CRM Hobbies on his eBay store and see the different things he has. Also, he's a quick phone call away if you contact him, and he's excellent customer service down there from the St. Louis area. So, Once again, that's it for this little review from 35th Scale Figures in Review.